Hi there. Okay, I'm making like a part, like a half part after my preparing for boot camp before I move on to the DEP and the meetings with your recruiters before you actually leave, because a lot of people are asking on my Facebook group for the shippers exactly what other people are bringing, because I guess they just want to know. Okay, this is what I'm bringing. I'm going to bring the clothes on my person and one change of clothes, because I'll talk about this later, but you will be going to the hotel the night before, so you do need a change of clothes, unless you want to wear the same clothes. That's up to you. I'm bringing my driver's license, my social security card, my direct deposit form for Navy Federal, a phone calling card, my cell phone, my address book, which I had showed you guys in my other video. And this is for females, so if you don't want to hear this, males, just cover your ears for like 2 seconds. I'm going to be bringing like sanitary products just for like 1 week. In the start guide, it says to bring them up for 1 week, just like some tampons or pads or whatever. Because I don't know about you guys, but it's going to be happening for me probably that first week that we're there. So I want to make sure I have stuff just in case they don't, if we don't have our yeoman picked out yet. Also, you can bring a small amount of makeup. My recruiter has said you can bring one mascara, one small eyeshadow. So I think they mean like, you know, those little like small ones. It is like one square of an eyeshadow. One lipstick. I'm not going to bring lipstick because I'm not even entirely sure what colors we're allowed to wear. Like, I don't know if I could wear this. I don't know if this is sufficient color because it has to match your skin tone. So I'm not even going to worry about that at that point. They're going to give us chapstick. I'm sure just a little shine will look good. And an eyeliner. So I'm going to bring probably like a natural color and maybe like just a regular eyeliner. But probably most definitely concealer. She didn't say whether we could bring concealer, but there's one by LA Girl that's like really small, just a really small tube. So I'm gonna try to bring that, because honestly, if I had no makeup but I had concealer to cover like my bags and stuff, I would be happy. I would be fine. Like, chapstick and concealer is fine. And that's only gonna be permitted for your graduation and maybe division photos. And at graduation. And I have heard some of the RDCs won't let you use it anyways. Like, they're so mean that you can't even use it, or they're gonna tell you to throw it away when you get there. So my advice that I've gotten from other people that have already gone through boot camp is don't throw it away. They're gonna tell you, if you have any makeup, throw it away in the bins. If you have this, if you have that. But they didn't throw it away, and then the RDCs later didn't care about it. Like, they just put it in their little thing and they knew that they couldn't use it. You cannot bring anything with glass or mirrors. So don't bring little compacts. If you're gonna try to bring a face powder, make sure it doesn't have a glass mirror, because they will throw that away at the USO before you even get to boot camp. There are no glass and no mirrors, so no eyelash curlers or anything like that, because those are like metal, so I don't think you can have anything metal. Also, like, what I'm gonna do for the hotel the day before is I'm gonna bring a disposable toothbrush and toothpaste so I can brush my teeth, and then I'll just throw it out. And I am gonna bring a small little container of pomade for my hair, because you can style your hair. It specifically says in words, "Ooh, female recruits may travel to RDC with their hair styled as desired." So I desire to style my hair probably something similar to this faux hawk or a little out of the side, because I don't like it just brushed down. And obviously, like, once I'm in boot camp, it doesn't really matter what I look like because it's not a fashion show. But up until the point that we get there, I'm going to want to look how I want to look. So I have an old pomade that's like empty. I don't know if you guys have one that's almost empty. And I'm just going to put my new product in that, use it, and then I'll throw it away on the way to the airport. I'm also going to bring a comb because I need a brush. My recommendation and what I'm going to do is I'm not going to bring anything that I would miss if they're going to throw it away. So the comb I'm going to bring is like just a little rinky-dink comb. That way if they throw it away, I'm not going to be bothered by it. Same with makeup. I'm not going to bring my expensive makeup because if they're going to throw it away, I mean, that's stupid. So I'm going to bring just like cheapy stuff that I just need. I'm not gonna wear makeup, when we go, like maybe the concealer, but I'm not gonna do like the eyeliner and mascara and all that stuff, because if you think about it, we're not gonna shower for like 2 days and we're gonna be kept awake, we're not gonna sleep, and we're gonna be going through this whole situation and on the fly, And I don't want this makeup all over my face. I don't want to look like a raccoon because after like a day of wearing it, one, it's terrible for your skin, but it's also going to like drip down and I don't want that. So I'm not wearing makeup. I don't know about you guys. Like I'm good. I am going to bring a small deodorant. It has to be 3 ounces or smaller, in order to fly with it. But also the RDCs will not allow you to keep it if it's any larger. So don't bring a normal size deodorant. Like find one of those real small ones. I'm going to bring $20 to $40 in cash. That way I have some money in case I do want to get something on the airport. I have heard it's recommended to eat at the airport before you go to the USO. If you go to the USO, they are not going to let you leave. They're not going to let you do nothing. So people are like, you know, they didn't get to eat forever. They didn't get to drink anything besides the water fountain and they couldn't pee. Whatever. I'm going to get something, a smoothie, food, coffee, I don't know what, something on the way to the USO so that I have something before, you know, that long journey. Maybe like people want an energy drink. I personally don't want to have that much sugar because you get the pee test, and you get your blood checked. And when they check your blood, I think they are checking your sugar, like for potential diabetics. And I don't want my sugar to be high. So I'm not going to have anything like with sugar. Like if I get a coffee, I probably won't put any sugar in it. And I'm also bringing a sweatshirt because it's going to be cold, guys. It's January in Illinois. It's going to be cold. I'm bringing a sweatshirt, and then I'll just ship it back. I mean, I don't care about the money to ship the stuff back. Like I said, my clothes, like, I don't have clothes that I want to donate that I don't care about because I already did that previous to as part of my preparation for boot camp. I already got rid of everything that I don't want or need. So I'm going to be shipping my clothes back to my boyfriend. Yeah, you can do, I mean, that's up to you though. So, this video is specifically for my January shippers on Facebook. So, I'm going to post this on Facebook, guys. This is what I'm bringing. If you have other questions about, you know, stuff to bring or you're not sure, my recruiter did answer that in, like, excess. So, I probably would have a good idea. So, you can go ahead and comment below. Thank you. Goodbye.